everybody, Flip and Danny here, founders of the Freedom Real Estate Group family of companies, and welcome to another episode of our podcast, which is called
Freedom Through Passive Income.
That's right. And welcome to another episode. This one is called Marriage, Business, and Investing.
Yeah, I thought this was a really good topic because we get asked a lot, how do you guys live and work together? You're married, you're still happy. And I did a Facebook post in Freedom Through Passive Income, that group, and I had said, how many of you guys are on the same page as your spouse in investing? And I'd say over half of the answers were nope. You know, one's conservative, one's risky, or like there's just different conversations about it. And so I just thought, again, we're at dinner and I'm always like thinking of different things and we have topics and I go and I'll text myself, oh, this is a good topic. So this is one that I texted myself just a couple nights ago. Might have been last night, I can't even remember. But
this last week has been sort of a blur.
Yes, yeah. It really has. So I thought we would just, you know, have a fireside chat about marriage and business and investing and let people kind of hear what our lives are like.
Right. Well, it's funny, this goes back way back in the day, you know, when we first met, we were working on cruise ships.
Yeah.
You know, and so here we are, we're working on cruise ships, and our cabin was about maybe 8 foot by 10 foot.
Yeah.
You know, and so we're, you know, tight quarters, you know, and we did that for a number of years before we got married. And I remember when we were getting married at our wedding, my brother, who is my best man, says, you know, I have no worry about these two in their lives, because if they can spend 8 years working on a cruise ship and not killing each other, I think they're going to be just fine.
Yeah.
You know, and it's, I don't know, maybe it's just, we just started working that way, and it's just, we've worked out great. It was, we, you know, we accommodate, you know, and we, it's funny because people, we did something recently, and the person that we were doing it with, she just started laughing. And she goes, you two are the exact opposite.
We are.
And it's funny because we are, but yet we aren't. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a lot of things that we aren't yin and yang,
yeah.
You know, but yet we are, you know, so it's so that's how you do it. So thank you for, hope you enjoyed this episode.
Here's an example of our opposites. Our brains are just wired differently. So when we will fold something, we do it the exact opposite of the other person.
And so, it drives you crazy.
Yeah, and I'll try and go, which way would I do it? Okay, he's going to do it this way. And I'll try and anticipate him. Lo and behold, he was trying to anticipate me. And we're still doing it the opposite way. Like, it's crazy. Everything, yeah. Every time, like, we both, we're going to wrap something. We're going to cook something. We're going to mix some ingredients. We do it the exact opposite. It is so consistent. It freaks me out sometimes. I'm like, oh, that is so weird. Why do we, our brains are just wired that way.
Oh, there's a restaurant. We're ordering food and we both ordered the same thing but completely different. It would be completely opposite of each other. And that was what it was. It's just more than once we do that.
And I
think it's hilarious.
So I thought we would share like some of the things that we've done, because as we've kind of grown, we were so flexible in our younger years. We don't care when we're both pretty good at risk.
I can't even bend over and touch my toes. Is it flexible? No, I'm just kidding.
But like it was a lot easier. But the older you grow, the more you start thinking about your nest egg and your retirement and the different things. And so we gave each other so much leeway and freedom with our relationship. And we just said, hey, if you're going to do it right. Mm-hmm. Buy the best. And spend that money. We only live life once. We'd had all these things that just allowed us to kind of do whatever it is we wanted. And we've lived such a great life. I have no regrets because we've just done so many things at a young age, including travel and all that stuff, including, you know, the money that we've spent, that like now we started to have to make changes because we don't want to keep on just going, hey, spend whatever you want, because the more we make, like, we're just going to keep spending it. And then what somebody called it, an inchworm, or you and I just had this conversation this morning about it creeps, you're a creeper.
Yeah,
it creeps up on you. Like you can.
But I'm not a creeper. I just want to make sure that that's straight.
True.
Yeah.
So it was like something that like it creeps. And I think it might've been Ariane and Chris that like it creeps up on you. And so like if you're making $10,000 a month doing something and then suddenly you get a raise and you're making $12,000, or you bought an investment property, somehow you got more income. Now you're at $12,000. Well, it's so easy to kind kind of go,
now we got can spend $12,000 a month.
And oh, shoot, I have no more passive income or money that I was putting into investments or in savings because I just creeped right up from that $10,000 to $12,000. And we've even seen this with this new Florida house. I said, we just jumped from this payment to this payment. I was like, crap. And I said, but hey, this is kind of the move that we wanted to make when we got at this age and we wanted to live in Florida, and it's got some cool asset protection pieces. And we're getting like $150,000 worth of equity right off the bat. And I was just like, all right, if it's meant to be, it will be.
That's right.
And it's meant to be, so we are moving. But that's those things that just creep up on you, and suddenly you're spending so much more money than you anticipated. So we like to do now these monthly checks. So not monthly, really. We need to probably start doing it monthly, but we do these checks where we go, do we need all this?
Yeah.
And we go, X, 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 X. And we
I actually do that. I actually do that way more than you know.
Yeah.
You only do it whenever I come and show you because I just want to see if there's anything on there that you want to get rid of. But I do that more often than you think.
Yeah.
Because it's like, I don't need that. I don't know. That's out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Yeah. So that's been a good learning lesson. One of the other things that we talked about was having separate bank accounts. So we've done everything, including all of our businesses, everything we own together, right? Our checking account, savings account, whatever it is, there's nothing that I own that you don't own. There's nothing that you own that I don't own. And that's just how we've lived our life, because we've really kind of, we met each other in a time of our lives where neither of us had anything. So we felt like that as we grew and as we built things up, we both deserved all of it.
I got nothing, you can have half of it.
So, but now that as we have more money, he likes to spend money on things that I don't necessarily want to spend money on. We just did this podcast about collectibles and nice cars versus passive income. So I'd rather take my bucket of money and put it in an investment that are going to give me passive income. Sometimes, not all the time, you want to take your bucket of money and buy something cool, like another car. And so I'm like, okay, if we're going to do that, let's actually separate our bank accounts. I get $20,000, you get $20,000, and I'm going to spend my $20,000 this way, and you're going to spend your $20,000. And then someday it's going to be a $50,000 each, and then $100,000 each, and then we'll just keep on going. But we'll have this, this is so totally apart from charitable giving and, you know, things like that. There's still things that we do together, right? The income comes in, we pay tithe, we pay our bills, we pay, you know, and then we're thinking about taking this separate. And we haven't even done it yet. So this is just a podcast about... This is a fireside chat. We have no script whatsoever.
Yeah, that's right.
We just said, let's talk about business and marriage and investing and sharing the conversations that we've had. Because a lot of people talk about this who are married. So I'll just get back to the point that we were talking about doing all of this collective stuff that we do together and then going into and then separating it so that you can do some of your stuff. And I'm not stressed out that some of our money is being spent on something that I wouldn't do.
Right.
And you're not stressed out that you want to buy this nice car and you deserve a nice car because you work very, very hard.
Right.
And Danny wants to go invest in passive income stuff.
Right. And plus the stuff that you invest in, I get half of those investments.
No, stop. We did have this like joking conversation. I was like, that was my money. That is my passive income.
Well, then you don't get to ride in my car.
So this is a perfect example, right? Like, and I will say that I want to give one more pointer from Chris and Ariane that I learned that I thought was really cool. And we're usually on the same page, so we've never had to do this, but they were talking about how, she wants 6 months of expenses, I think, you know, in reserves. And then he wants 12 months of expenses in reserves.
Right.
Like he's just a little bit he just wants to be safer.
Yeah.
And so something that he said I thought was really super powerful, and it was the person who wants more, you both have to meet them. So she wants six, he wants 12. They need to have 12 months because Chris can't sleep at night if they only have six, right? And so that's not fair to Chris and that marriage and that relationship. I thought that was so, I was like, I would have like said, can we go in the middle? Like, let's go to nine. So I'm really sleeping at night and you're like, okay, I'm only 3 months off, right? Something like that. But I thought that was really cool. But I'm going to end up with this. My ending of this is that I do feel that you and I are blessed. Because we built the businesses together and we're in real estate together. So when we're out on date night, we have so much to talk about that, it is work and it's But it's like a husband and wife conversation. Right. It's like, how was your day, honey?
Oh, yeah.
And we literally do that because I don't know what you're doing in your office and you don't know what I'm doing. Heck, you learn half of the stuff I'm doing in my office on these podcasts.
True.
So we can talk about real estate, and it's not necessarily that we're still doing business. We're just talking about each other's day and sharing information that is very engaging for both of us because it is our lives and it is our business. Yeah. So there are, you know, circumstances where other people might not experience that level that we have, but I just think it's all, I think there's lessons in all of it. And I think that you have to just figure out how to have the win for both of you, whatever that may be. And you can do the book that we just talked about, The Road Less Stupid.
Yep.
And then you can ask yourself a question and use that hour in the morning going, how am I, me and my husband or me and my spouse have that, find this win? And you can just write down different ideas and then at dinner, then go talk about them.
That's right.
Right? All right. Do you have anything else? Sorry, I was just sharing all of our miscellaneous nonsense. No. You probably didn't want it the whole entire world to hear. But.
Yeah, no, I'm fine with that. But I do have to complain about the girl that's in the office next to me. Man, she talks so loud. Oh my gosh, I can't get anything done in my office.
Our walls are thin.
Yeah, they are. They
you're always like, so I heard you talking to so and so.
I know what meeting you're in. Anyway, well, we hope that you enjoyed this episode. Make sure you're heading on over to our website, Freedom Capital Investment, to join our Freedom Capital Investments.
Yeah. .com. Yes.
To join our investor club.
Yes.
And also, we have the swag on there. And what Danny's got the hat on.
Yes.
Invest smart, live happy.
That's right.
Also, we're on all the social medias and all that fun stuff. But we like to end all of our episodes with
invest smart,
live happy.
Bye, everybody.
Nothing on this show should be considered specific, personal, or professional advice. Please consult an appropriate tax, legal, real estate, financial, or business professional for individualized advice. Opinions and information on this show are not guaranteed. All investment strategies have the potential for profit or loss.